disturb the princess, sir, but there are some reporters here.
Oh,
and they...
dear. We've been trying so hard to avoid publicity.
Oh, shall I send them away,
sir? Oh, no. I suppose one must cater to the press. Yeah. Send them in.
This way, gentlemen.
Oh, make yourselves right at home, gentlemen. I'll try my best to arrange an interview with the princess as soon as she's had her luncheon. Just take off your skimmers, take off your hats, and make yourselves comfortable.
You're sure you still want the lunch that you ordered?
Oh, yes, indeed. Bring it right in.
Oh, and the meat, too?
Certainly.
Oh, all right, boys.
Well, I know you. Weren't you on the London Times?
I just don't remember. Sam, was I on the London Times?
I don't know much about your past life.
Oh, well, one can make mistakes. Thought I'd met you someplace before, but of course...
Say, she isn't going to eat all that herself, is she?
I'll admit that it is a strange custom, but ever since the princess escaped...
Escaped from where?
From the Turkish harem into which she was sold as a mere child, and from which she effected her escape with the aid of this faithful gentleman over here. Since then, the princess has never missed a single meal with Stambouli.
With who?
With Stambouli.
And is that Stambouli?
No. That... Gentlemen, the princess.
Get to work on the tea.
Say, what is Stambouli? Is that what she's eating?
Oh, no. Is Stambouli ready?
Yes, he is all ready. I just looked.
Come with me, gentlemen. Allah Akbar Stambouli. I shouldn't have told you so much about the princess, boys, but since I've let you have the story, would you mind leaving out the fact that Merle Farrell, the producer, saw the princess do that dance of hers in Paris and has engaged her for a featured role in his new Follies? You see, Merle wants to bust out with the announcement himself.
Well, it's a good story, anyway.
Say, as one liar to another, haven't I seen that lion act at Coney Island?